Hello and welcome to Inside the PGTI, where we have a royal treat in store for you over the next half an hour. We'll be in the city of Maharajas, which hosted the 2017 Jaipur Open in the month of September. This would be the historic inaugural edition of the tournament. And fittingly, it would be held in a city that compares favorably to most others when it comes to history and heritage. Jaipur's numerous forts and palaces reveal to visitors its fascinating narrative of military tradition, imperial rule, and tales of battles past. For the golfers who had descended upon the city to take part in battles of a different kind, there would be much to take inspiration from as they soaked in some of those sights and sounds. A vibrant, colourful city of 3 million people, the Pink City, named thus when it was coloured pink in 1876 to welcome the Prince of Wales, would see yet another glorious chapter written in its proud history. For those who had come here to play its first ever tournament, the occasion was one to be savoured in a city that has just so much to offer.
The Lal Mas, the Handi Biryani, the people here are so friendly, so nice. There's so much culture and heritage, Indian heritage over here. I used to come here as a kid with my parents and my grandparents to, Jantar Mantar or any of the other historical venues and landmarks out here. And every time I come here, I learn something new about the city.
The locale would be the premier golfing venue of not just Jaipur, but all of Rajasthan, the Rambagh Golf Club. The region's faithful love this course because of its picturesque location and beautiful surroundings. Apart from its verdant character itself, which soothes and refreshes the senses, the course offers numerous other views for the players as they walk around. With views of the Rambagh Palace Hotel, Moti Dungri Fort, Nahargarh Fort and the Birla Planetarium, giving golfers lots of visual relief during days of intense competition. For those who've been coming here for the past couple of decades, the transition from its early genesis to near perfection now is something to indeed write home about.
It was on the old PGAI circuit and it was the Rambagh Open in 1982. So I was a little youngster, tagging along with some of the older guys and came to play here. And we played on oil browns and there was hardly any grass. And, now after all these years, you have a lush green golf course here. So I think the credit goes to all the members of the club here to, keep this place going for all these years and, not just keep it going, but improving year on year.
A challenging par 70 championship course with a yardage of 6,303, the Rambagh Golf Club was strategically designed on sandy loam soil. With heavy rains lashing the course for a couple of days leading up to the 2017 Jaipur Open, the challenges for those in the fray, including those who had played here many times before, would still be considerable.
It's not that easy. I mean, it's a short golf course, but it's pretty tricky right now. Some of the holes you really have to hit a fairway and give yourself a chance. And I'm here after a really long time. I think last time I came here in 2008. And so a lot of memories, but still, I mean, the course is playing a little slow, so that's the reason, I think.
Well, for me, one of the challenges, firstly, there's two. I think number one is off the tee, and then you've obviously got. These huge trees in the middle of the fairways, so you've got to think about what you're hitting off the tee and in terms of ball position. And then secondly, it's going to be for the week, actually in the entire week, is actually learning on how to putt on these greens. For me, it's they're quite slow, so actually I think that's going to be the big factor of the week on the greens.
Those challenges, though, would be seen as an opportunity for the participants who comprise the best in the business in India. This sort of course, with its specific challenges on specific holes, easily separates the best from the rest, the contenders from the pretenders.
There are a couple of holes. Like if you see in the second half, I think the 16th hole is a long par 3, a long par 4. So that's a tight hole. And they are like on the starting like first three holes, first, second, third, they are tight holes. So there are a couple of holes you have to watch out, and if you can take them up par, for sure you'll be having an edge over the field.
That was the stated aim for all the title aspirants as they went into what promised to be a memorable first ever edition of the Professional Golf Tour of India's Jaipur Open. The tournament would carry a prize purse of 30 lakh rupees. and its very staging would be the culmination of the best joint efforts of the PGTI and the Rajasthan State Sports Council. Presented by Rajasthan Tourism in a bid to further encourage the growth of golf in the state, the Jaipur Open brought with it the promise of some mouth-watering action. Laying down the gauntlet for all the others jockeying for the coveted prize was Delhi's Ashok Kumar. The 34-year-old, who is now based at Gurugram's DLF Golf and Country Club, produced a stunning round of 8 under par 62. On a comeback trail of sorts, after missing a number of events due to health issues related to blood sugar and hypertension, Ashok showed no signs of grappling with injuries or ill health.
मैं बहुत ज़्यादा बीमार भी था काफ़ी ज़्यादा मेरा health इतना अच्छा नहीं था तो मैं practice नहीं कर पाया था लेकिन मैं अब continue में golf में हूँ और मैं I hope continue में अच्छा golf खेलूँगा और आपको अच्छा result मिलेगा देखने के लिए.
His card embellished considerably by the 3 birdies he made on the last 4 holes. Ashok felt comfortable enough to reveal just how desperate he was to bring out his best form from the past and make the most of opportunities like this one, given his prolonged periods of absence due to his poor health.
No, yeah, definitely. I don't play so many matches this year, and this is my second match. So definitely, I will try to play the best I was doing before. And that I am repeating again. So I hope you will get a good golf experience.
Matching Ashok almost stroke for stroke on day one was Noida's Vikrant Chopra. One of the most consistent performers this season, the seasoned 37-year-old professional had been so near yet so far in the 2 events in Gujarat that immediately preceded the Jaipur Open, a trend he was eager to buck.
Last event in Kentsville, the last round, it was a birdie-less round. So I guess all the birdies were for the first round here. So I'm pretty happy about it. Last 2 weeks, we played pretty quick greens and at the end of the day, you need to putt well and chip well, you know. It's not a very long course, so you just have to keep the ball in play and obviously if it's in play, you know, you'll get a lot of birdie opportunities. So I think that's the key, you got to keep it in play because the rough is quite up. We've never played such thick rough here.
Meanwhile, another man to impress was Divyanshu Bajaj, who hails from Kolkata. With the memories of his career-best top-5 finish at the Asian Tour event in Bengaluru in the previous month still fresh in his memory, Bajaj reproduced that kind of prime form. His impressive round of 6-under-64 went a long way towards banishing the ghosts of tournaments past.
I didn't play the last 2 events properly, the one in both the Gujarat events. I just completely lost feel in my putting and I've been working on it during this off time that we had in between Kentsville and here, and it's working now. Let's see how, I hope the next 3 rounds are going to be good as well.
To sum up the first day's play then, just 4 shots separated the top 12 golfers. 2017 Order of Merit leader Shamim Khan and fellow Delhiite Pawan Kumar were tied for 4th at 5-under-65. A slightly disappointing aspect for the crowd, though, was the showing of one of the pre-tournament favourites, Rashid Khan, who carded in a 1-under-69 to be tied 31st. On that note, it's time for us to take our first break here on the show. But do stick around. When we come back, we'll show you how some of the golfers were horsing around, quite literally, in front of some royalty, as strokes of a different kind enraptured the crowds at the Rambagh Club. Welcome back. After a closely and keenly contested first round of the 2017 Jaipur Open at the Rambagh Golf Club, there was a sense of anticipation in the air as the players warmed up for round two. This would be the crucial stage of the tournament, where the contenders would take a step closer to the coveted prize, while roughly half the field would be eliminated after the application of the cut. Fittingly, for a round of such immense significance, there was a tour record from that man delighting the local faithful, who were seeing a major professional golf tour of India event for the very first time. Vikrant Chopra scripted history by following up his first round 8-under-62 with a 7-under-63. It gave him the record for the lowest two-day PGTI total at 15-under.
I was just playing my game, you know. I didn't expect to shoot so many birdies and just hitting the greens, and I know I'm putting well, so that's what I did, and that's how it happened. You know, I canned a few good putts, and that kick-started my round. 15-under, it's a great run. I've never shot 15-under in the first 2 days. And generally, 15-unders are pretty winning scores, you know. So I'm really happy about it. So hopefully I'll get a good night's sleep today.
At that point in time, it looked as though victory in this tournament would be but a foregone conclusion for the Noida golfer. So he knew guarding against complacency would be his biggest challenge from that point onwards.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely. Why not? You know, hopefully the game is such that 1 week you'll really play well. And so I think you've got to be consistent, and you have to believe in yourself, and that's about it. So I hope this kick starts my seasons itself.
Daylight separated Vikrant from the chasing pack, with a couple of the others closest to him 5 strokes behind. Shamim Khan was one of them. The PGTI's all-time highest money earner was playing remarkably consistent golf. His second round of 5-under-65 kept him in the hunt.
Overall, काफी अच्छा है. Hitting भी काफी अच्छी हो रही है और putting अभी इतना better नहीं है. But हाँ, कि जिस हिसाब से hitting की है, उस हिसाब से average कम ही है. Golf course short है, थोड़ा easier भी है क्योंकि short course है और बारिश वाली थोड़ा सा soft है तो easy खेलता है थोड़ा.
The quiet and reticent Sanjeev brought those qualities to his game as well, quietly sneaking up on Shamim with a simple, straight and safe game and keeping clear, attainable targets in mind.
अगले दो दिन हमें regularly 4-under, 5-under target हमारा 4-under के रहेगा.
At the halfway stage, there was a commanding 5-stroke lead for Vikrant at the top. Round 1 leader Ashok, on the other hand, slipped to tied 12th. At the other end of the spectrum, the cut was declared at 1-under-139. 54 professionals would make the cut, progressing to the money rounds. All 4 local Jaipur golfers, by the way, missed the cut, including leading professional Vishal Singh. The Rambagh campus in Jaipur is famous locally, not just for the golf club, but also for its polo grounds, which regularly see some of the biggest names in the world turning out. Members of India's World Cup team can be frequently seen sharpening their skills and also competing at this hallowed venue. It's a long tradition that stays well alive and is laying the foundation for India's future polo players as well, thanks to the historical patronage it's received from members of the Jaipur royal family. The current Skyen, Savai Padmanabh Singh, was a star attraction there for those who had walked across from the golfing greens to catch a glimpse of this fast, exciting sport.
Rambagh has become the home of polo and for golf. We are basically neighbors. We share the same compound, and we have a lot of the polo players play golf. A lot of the golf players play polo, so we have a very friendly relationship with them. Interestingly, there's also a lot of similarity between the two sports. I don't happen to be an expert golfer or anything, but I've been to the driving range a few times, and the way they swing this, the way they swing the club is very similar to the way we swing our mallet. So when I went to the driving range for the first time, I smacked the ball completely and it went so far. And then I realized it's the same swing.
The old enthusiasts there still look back fondly at the days of Maharaja Savai Man Singh II, a 10-goal player who took the Jaipur team to victory in the 1957 Polo World Cup. It's that kind of formidable legacy that the young Maharaja now aims to carry forward. His stated aim has been to bring the World Cup playoffs to Jaipur with the help of some good sponsors and make Jaipur a major destination for the sport again, as had been the case in the last century. Back to the adjacent golf club now, which is fast making the city a major destination for golf in its own right. And the competitors still left in the fray were gearing up for the penultimate round of competition as the business end of the 2017 Jaipur Open began in right earnest on the third day. Overnight leader Vikrant Chopra continued his strong charge towards the glittering silverware with a rock-solid round of 2-under-68, which took his overall tally to 17-under for the tournament. After his 2 big bang rounds earlier, this one did seem decidedly quieter, but it proved enough to keep him ahead of the chasing pack by just the proverbial nose.
Yeah, obviously, you know, you expect a lot out of yourself after those two rounds, and you know, probably you're looking at a 4-5 under at least. But I hit the ball well, you know, it was pretty close to the pins, and I mean, the putts just didn't drop in today, you know. So I'm happy. It's all right. Well, you know, it's a bogey-free round, so I'm pretty happy about it. I had two birdies. I hit the ball really well. The putts just didn't go in, so I think I've saved a few putts for tomorrow.
The 37-year-old had dropped just one bogey in the first three rounds, so there would be no question about the fact that he would go into the decisive bend as the title favourite. While that in itself would put some additional pressure on Vikrant, he was determined to stay in the present with the others hot on his heels come day four.
No, you tend to, you know, your eyes tend to go and have a look at the leaderboard. But all said and done, you know, you just have to play your own game and that's it. You know, if you keep looking at the leaderboard, I don't think it makes much of a difference.
Surprise package Sanjeev Kumar of Lucknow had sharply cut Vikrant's lead, which would stand at just two strokes after Sanjeev's standout round of 5-under-65 in round three. The 25-year-old who turned professional in 2011 was brimming with confidence. With a top 10 finish at the Asian Tours 2016 Panasonic Open and a runner-up place at the 2017 PGTI Chittagong event to boast, coming into the Jaipur event, Sanjeev threw his hat into the ring for the Holy Grail, courtesy of his strong showing on the front nine in particular.
Today's round was very good, but starting with a little bit, like first hole birdie miss, second miss, second hole pe kuch 5 feet ka putt tha, wo miss kiya maine, easy birdie. Uske baad birdie nahi hua, fir last first birdie 5th hole, 6 par, 7 par, 8 eagle ho gaya. Eagle thoda confident badh gaya mera.
Following just a stroke behind Sanjeev in the overall stakes, which were becoming very interesting indeed, was Delhi golfer Honey Baisoya. He produced the day's best card of 5-under-65 to rise to third place. The remaining title contender at the end of the second last round would be the PGTI's 2017 Order of Merit leader Shamim Khan. Having started the day in tied second, Shamim dropped a couple of places to fourth at 13-under-197 overall. So as you can see over there, it was all delectably set up heading into the decisive stretch. Gurugram-based Manu Gandas and Delhi's Vinod Kumar sharing 5th place there at 12-under overall, 5 strokes behind the odds-on favourite Vikrant. With the course playing relatively easy, there couldn't have been a closer finish on the cards in this, the historic inaugural edition of the PGTI Jaipur Open. So then, we'll nip into one final break here on the show. But don't go anywhere. When we return, we'll bring to you one of the rarest glimpses of an extremely uncommon phenomenon in professional sport, a father and son competing in the same event and rewriting the record books in more ways than one. Welcome back. The 2017 Jaipur Open, the inaugural edition of the event, made history in more ways than one. The extremely rare occurrence of a father and son competing against each other added novelty value to proceedings. Tour veteran Firoz Ali Mullah and his son Imran were among those in the fray. Contrary to what many would expect though, it wasn't an early start for Imran after watching his dad.
When I started golf at the age of 15, I played my first tournament 50 over. Then I think of, may I do better in future? Then I started playing tournaments. Then I have seen in myself that I am progressing slowly. Then I talked to my father, said, please give me some tips how to manage course and all. Then he said, okay, I will. And then from at the age of 15 to today, I'm 26 years old. Now my handicap is scratched.
मैं अपना टूर में ज़्यादातर बिजी रहता था. मैं इसको जूनियर क्लब में मेंबरशिप दिया हुआ था, सब जूनियर तो मैंने अपने बेटे को बोला बाबा गोल्फ क्या चीज़ है आप उसको एटिकेट आप समझो फिर उसके बाद गोल्फ खेलो हमारा आपका बैक है जब आपको आप गोल्फ खेलोगे आपके जो भी आपको मिस्टेक होगा आप हमको पूछिएगा.
This is the third instance of a father-son combine on the PGTI. Mohammad Saleem and Mohammad Sanju, as well as Gus Ram and Kapil Kumar, were the two previous ones. In this particular case, though, the now 47-year-old Firoz was in no hurry to rush his son into the sport. He waited until Imran had finished his MBA and made sure he had an alternate career option in the event of injury or lack of success.
आपके जो age है, मैं वो age में मैं कम से कम 10 tournament जीत गया था. वो एज में मैंने 26 में मैं कम से कम 20-25 टूर्नामेंट जीत गया था. अब अभी तक कुछ नहीं की क्योंकि आप पहले स्टडी करो पढ़ाई करो पढ़ाई के बाद जो भी होगा मैं आपके लिए मैं फ्री हूँ मैं आपको जितना भी टाइम दे सकते हैं मैं उतना दूँगा.
With the two competing on tour now, they can easily feed off each other and redress any flaws that might have crept in almost instantly.
Sometimes he do not hit well in practice. Then I tell him, your swing is going from out to in. You are overtopping your swing. So for him, I am his mentor, and for me, he is my mentor. Whatever I do mistake today in game, he teach me at 7 o'clock. Today you should not chip with low wedge. You should roll here. Each and every day, every evening, we discuss among each other. I'm little not confident with my driver right now. So that's his strong point and that's my weak point. Only driving.
While the more flamboyant Firoz has often been jokingly called the Indian Nick Faldo because of his stylish attire and occasionally flashy shades, Imran is the more understated of the two at present. His father, however, feels that's only because his otherwise more colourful son isn't comfortable with flaunting his sartorial style. Since he hasn't achieved anything noteworthy, something Firoz hopes will change sooner rather than later.
आपको सुपरस्टार बनना है, स्टार नहीं बनना है, आपको क्वालिटी बनना है, क्वांटिटी नहीं बनना है. आज फिरोज अली को कौन जानता है? क्योंकि हम इंडियन ओपन जीता है, मैं हमेशा टॉप लेवल में आता है. इसके लिए लेकिन आज देखो सबको आज यंगस्टर आ रहे हैं क्योंकि हमारा जो लेवल था आज आस्ते में डाउन हो रहा है. मेरा डाउन हमारा पोजिशन अभी सीनियर टूर में जा रहा है. अब जो जूनियर है जो यंग स्टार है वो लोग तो आप क्योंकि हम टूर को तो वो लोग ही आगे बढ़ाएगा ना.
After 3 rounds, though, it was quite apparent how long away Imran still has to go if he has to follow in his father's great footsteps. While Firoz was tied 41st at 1-under overall after the penultimate round, his son would only cheer from him from the sidelines, having missed the cut a round earlier, having shot a combined 9-under over 2 days. Firoz, though, wasn't in title contention on the decisive day. It would largely be a four-way battle there between runaway leader Vikrant Chopra and the likes of surprise package Sanjeev Kumar, consistent 2017 performer Honey Baisoya and Order of Merit leader Shamim Khan. To everyone's surprise, overnight leader Vikrant Chopra's form kept tapering off, progressively diminishing his title hopes. Vikrant produced his worst round of the tournament, a 1-under par 69 at the worst possible time. His strategy of playing safe seemed to be working until the 12th, but 3 bogeys in the next 6 holes ruined his chances of grabbing the coveted silverware. In the risk-reward toss-up, Honey Baisoya's much more aggressive approach started paying rich dividends. Overnight third and 3 off the lead, Honey's strategy was to try to capitalize on the first 6 holes, which by and large played to his strengths as a golfer.
Starting se bas yehi soch raha tha ki main apne aap ko kahin kharab na karu kyunki un holes pe main score kar sakta tha aur par थोड़ी बहुत ड्राइव खराब आने की वजह से मैंने उन होलों पे खराब कर दिया.
With both Vikrant and Honey slipping up, Shamim Khan needed no second invitation to seize the opportunity. The 2012 Order of Merit winner made an early charge with 3 birdies on the first 10 holes. Meanwhile, Lucknow's Sanjeev Kumar, who had come into the round in overnight second, had almost a mirror image of Vikrant's round. He too slipped and likewise surrendered his title claims after shooting a final round of 3-under 67. Kolkata's Viraj Madappa also rose into contention for a brief spell thanks to a sizzling round of 9-under 61, the best card of the day overall. He managed an eagle to go with 7 birdies. But it wasn't enough for the man currently leading the Emerging Player of the Year stakes to challenge for the title. So eventually it became a 2-horse race for the crown. And as is the case so often, luck would play a decisive role in the eventual outcome as Shamim Khan tried to outsprint Hani Baisoya to the finishing line.
मेरे लिए टर्निंग पॉइंट था सबसे ज़्यादा जो 17 की टी शॉट थी ऑलमोस्ट वो ओबी थी ओबी इसमें एक पेड़ में लगकर बॉल बाहर आई और उसके बाद वहाँ से एक गुड शॉट के बाद में कोई 8 से 10 फुट के अंदर बॉल गई तो मुझे लगा कि अब इस पट को पिलाने से शायद मैं जीत सकता हूँ.
So with that eagle helping Shamim finish on a high and 2 strokes ahead of Hani, it all came down to this on the 18th. Hani needed to nail it straight in from the bunker to force a 2-way playoff.
Bunker shot मैंने काफी अच्छा मारा था. मैं बहुत देर से जितना भी time विक्रांत चोपड़ा को लग रहा था हाजिर से निकलने में, मैं उस time में सिर्फ वही सोच रहा था कि मुझे इस shot को पिलाना कैसे है, इसको chip in कैसे करना है. मैंने काफी सारी line देखी, बहुत बारी line देखी, काफी बारी swing किए, काफी पानी पिया. काफी ट्राई किया खुद को काम करने के लिए उस ट्रिप को पिलाने के लिए, पर अच्छा जिप मारा वो पिलानी हो तो बैड लक.
So it was Shamim who emerged triumphant by just that one shot. His aggressive approach, complemented by a brilliant stroke of luck, no pun intended, had landed him the holy grail. Heartbreak then for Hani, who missed out on a 4th professional golf tour of India title. For the Delhi-based Shamim, on the other hand, it would be a 2nd title for the season. More than anything, it showed the strength and depth of the field on the PGTI. Even creating a 2-round record of 15 under didn't prove enough for Vikrant, as 5 players eventually jostled for the championship. Shamim thus extended his overall lead in the season's Order of Merit stakes. Bidding to win only his 2nd Order of Merit crown and his 1st in 5 years, the winner of 14 professional titles put clear daylight between himself and the chasing pack after picking up the winner's check of 4.5 lakh rupees.
उस फॉर्म के मुकाबले तो खैर इतना स्ट्रॉन्ग नहीं है, लेकिन अगर आपको ऑर्डर मेरिट जीतना है या नंबर वन खत्म करना है तो एटलीस्ट एक आपको एक बड़ा टूर्नामेंट जीतना पड़ेगा, जो कि साल में 3-4 टूर्नामेंट हमारे होते हैं, सीजी और बिल्ट वगैरह, जो भी जितने भी बड़े बड़े हमारे टूर्नामेंट है, एटलीस्ट एक टूर्नामेंट आपको जीतना पड़ेगा, तब आप जीतने के लिए सोच सकते हैं.
And that's all we have for you on the show today. This is where we bid goodbye, leaving you to savor some of the enduring images of Shamim Khan's truly astonishing tournament win.